Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of WebInformant.tv. I'm David Strom, your host and reviewer. Today, we're looking at version 12 of Symantec's Endpoint Protection Small Business Edition. It's a powerful protective application that can secure your small network, and we're looking at its main console that shows you the current overall status, what endpoints are being managed, and whether any threats have been detected. The product is geared towards small businesses that don't have a lot of IT depth or experience, and it installs quickly and is very simple to set up. It includes its own web server and doesn't require that your network be running Active Directory or even a Windows file server, although it can leverage these pieces. It automatically sets up a series of protective policies, groups of computers, and rules for protecting your endpoints in your network. Here we're looking at the default group screen. There are two major pieces to the product: a management server called the Symantec Protection Center that can install on just about any Windows server as long as it isn't running Vista, and the client piece that provides the protection, which we're looking at here, which runs on Vista along with older Windows versions. This is not just an antivirus product, but incorporates three other main technologies to keep your PCs from being compromised: a desktop firewall that can beef up Windows' own puny attempts in that area, proactive threat protection that handles unknown and zero-day attacks, and a sophisticated collection of intrusion prevention tactics that we'll get to in a moment. Once you install the server, which took us about 5 minutes, you next bring up the client install wizard that you see here. It is very simple. There are three different choices for the installation: to create an executable setup file, send an email link that points to the setup so that each user can perform their own installation, or push the installation with no user interruption or action using the admin logon on the end user's PC. After the client has been installed, the protective features are automatically enabled, and there is nothing more to do. It's that easy. The value in this product is that simple reports that can keep you current with what's happening on your network without burying you in copious logs with every event. Go to the Reports Schedule Reports tab, and you can see a daily and weekly status report that are set by default. If you want more, click on the Add button, and you can select from four different canned reports and schedule it to run at certain frequencies. What happens when you hit an infected website or try to download a virus? Here you see a warning message that pops up on the client-side PC. There are also summary statistics that are displayed over on the console as well. One of the things I liked about the product was the reporting portion of the management console is remotely accessible, which is great for VARs and consultants that need to manage the machine from afar. You just bring up your web browser and the IP address, and you'll see this screen in your browser. Another thing I like is the product has a lot going on under the covers, but doesn't intrude with a lot of annoying dialogues to individual end users, like some personal firewalls. Here we're looking at the Zone Alarm firewall, and what happens when we bring up IE and just look at Google, it peppers us with a lot of allow or block questions. The difference is notable with Symantec's product. There isn't anything for the end user to do. They are just being protected as they go about their business with no annoying dialogues. Going back to the management console, here we see a list of threat signatures that come turned on for the intrusion prevention module. We get there by going to IP policy, then exceptions, and then adding an exception to our policy. When we took this video, we had more than 1,600 threats cataloged, and there's a convenient link to the threat database on Symantec's website. Another thing is there a free 30-day trial with unlimited licenses to the full product. The software is very competitively priced, with client licenses ranging between $35 to $45 each and between $16 to $20 if you're using any non-Symantec AV products, making the software a very good deal indeed. Finally, there's a series of screens that will show you your licensing profile. Click on the link in the main console and bring up this information. There's also a different version of the SEP product with more options for larger enterprise installations that include removable device controls and the ability to lock users from installing any new applications. Here you can see a screen from that product. What are things I didn't like? I wish the default was to replace the standard Windows firewall with the Symantec version, which is a much more capable because Microsoft's firewall doesn't block outbound traffic. And these days, with the level of phishing and blended attacks, that can be a big weakness. Here we're looking at the various firewall rules that you can enable and customize by going to Policies, Firewall, Add a Policy, and go to the Firewall Rules. Another drawback is this product is Windows only. It would be nice to have something that works on Macs too. Thanks for watching webinformant.tv. This is David Strom. Feel free to email me comments to david@strom.com.